Today I'm turning this old doghouse into a chicken tractor. Well, it's been sitting at the back of the property. I dug it up and the bottom was rotten out, so I took all that out of there. So I have these new 4x4s. I'm gonna lay it down. I'm gonna extend two of them right out the front. So we'll have one here all the way out. I'll put one along the back and then along this top right here. Well, I've got the bottom secured in there. See, I got the 4x4s. This is all scrap stuff, so it's a little bit of a warp one right there, but look at that. I re-lined everything inside. It's all supported real good back there. And I think the center one, this, I'm gonna cut that off because now this is all gonna be covered. So I'm gonna make my uppers that look just like the lower here and get that all put together. Get some screen on it, put a lid on the top so I can open it with the hinge door for access for food and water. And I'll probably put a rope somewhere along here and some wheels in the back so I can drag this thing around. So I remember about 10 or 12 years ago, I was doing a job and they were having a garage sale there, and I saw these sitting on the driveway. And these are hard, solid tires, no fill, they run flat, with this great axle. And you know, I bought these 50 cents for this one and 50 cents for this one, and I haven't had to use them, I had to have a purpose for them here 10 or 12 years later. But look at this, perfect, because I'm going to mount these right here, something like that. But here's the upper structure. I got that all taken care of now, and it's looking pretty good. I'm still gonna make a door like right here on top so we can lift the food and water in, but it's pretty much time to wrap this thing up with some barb or some chicken wire. So that's next. All right, so I've had success now with the chicken tractor. I introduced them into the yard here with the other ones. So let's go take a look. It took me all day today to get that thing the way I wanted it, but there it is. 10 meat birds in there and enjoying it with their water and their food. It was an old doghouse. Those wheels they didn't work out as planned. They were real close to working. Real close to working, but they just didn't work out as planned. So back to the drawing board with those. Now that it's in here though, it won't be moved all that much. But it's not bad. They worked for a little while. It was just dragging too much here at the back side on the ground there. It was just dragging too much, so I had to get a couple, you know, a dolly cart back here and one up there. So it's almost 7 feet of outdoor, or you know, open space right there, and just under 4 feet of covered space. So it's not bad for 10 chickens, 10 meat birds. They'll do all right with it. So all in all, this is gonna be the first night out, and we'll see how it goes, but so far so good. We'll have to see how Otis and the hens react to having all these new feathered friends in here. Otis, he's a grouchy one, and he very territorial. But these are some really good hens. This one right here is Bigfoot. We've had her since day one. She's probably 4 years old now, five maybe. She's real friendly. She's one of our biggest ones. Okay, Otis, we know you rule the roost, buddy. You know, he's a ruler of the roost here. But this little guy right here, see that little banny? he is coming along real nice, and that's a rooster too. And if I can get him to crow on camera here, it would be so funny because he's just learning how to do it, and it's hilarious. Looks like it's nighttime. These ones go up early, these banties. They get in their roost early and call it a night. And they're the first ones out of all these chickens. It's the banties that are first out in the morning. You hear them, they're all getting busy. Getting ready for bed, getting all tucked in. Look at her in there.